Hello, Malcolm, and hello, world. Welcome to episode 8 of Planetbase. We are going to jump in right where we left off. Last episode, it was the decision between bars and bots, and the colonists didn't get a vote. We're establishing bot production. We just barely have the steel to make like one bot a week or something, but we're gonna work on that. We've got more steel production capacity in, and please don't die within the first 30 seconds of loading. That would just depress me. And the power system looks like it's gonna hold together. I think spares are holding. Yeah, spares are holding. Food's holding. Starch and bioplastic production is quite good, so I could technically shut down a bioplastic temporarily. I have one down already. I could shut down another bioplastic to free up hands. Disable structure, turn off power. To free up hands until we need the bioplastic, because we need the steel a lot more. We have a lot of steel drinking stuff now. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 steel drinking things on here. And 4 steel producing things, so you can see where we're actually ores ahead of steel. We're going to watch the ore to steel balance, and if we see a situation where ore gets ahead of steel, we're going to go ahead and demolish a bioplastics and put in an extra steel. In fact, we might just go ahead and do that right now. No. What do we got here? A trader. Good stuff. And our laser's working away. Isn't that nice? That is great. Okay, there's big plans. But first, let's trade. He's a food trader. Well, he's got money. And I've got food. Oh, okay, we don't take the money first. First, we load him up with junk that we don't need. Until he's full. Then we take the money. We got 165 here. We won't get all his money. He's got a really low commission, 40%. So in fact, we can't quite get all his money, but pretty close. 165, it's perfect. We're going to go ahead and trade. I like it. That's what this base was meant to be all about. Trading for money until we can afford to buy the little luxuries that will make the base more functional, like a couple of patents. We could really use some patents. So we're definitely just gonna monitor steel production and see how we do, and keep an eye on everything else. I don't think we're gonna change personnel right now. Biology, meh. You know, I do push them a little hard. She's not too unhappy. I do push biology a little hard. There's another one. She's not too unhappy. It could be that I should staff up biology, but, I mean, the base is close to its functional limits. Drawing 10 out of 13 water, exactly. Now, sometimes we produce more water than that. But I'm still wondering about putting in the bar. I would really like to give them a bar. They obviously need to build up some production first, and loading this ship is not going to help them with building up production in any way, shape, or form, of course. Look, they're all thronging through the halls, carrying stuff to the ship and to elsewhere, I guess. Starch, yeah, he's carrying it to the ship. Which one are you? CR3, and he's wearing out. We need them bots, because they will take the load off. As soon as those bots die, our workers are going to be working harder. All that needs is a semiconductor, and we've got arms shut down, right? Yeah, arms are shut down for the moment, and arms are actually loaded with a semiconductor anyway, which is pretty nice. So hopefully someone will get a semiconductor in there, and that'll happen. And hopefully nothing else will fall off too badly because we added that in. We may have to get more workers. Gonna hold off. Just leave bioplastics a bit disabled there. Sell starch. Well, yeah, good construction robot. See, it'd be nice to have the patent for them. Of course, that will require more steel production, more semiconductor production. To get 2 bot factories going, we need another facility making semiconductors. And, okay, well, steel production's cruising along. It is building up little by little. And it will find its way into these various machines where it's needed. And it's found its way here. So that's just waiting for a semiconductor, and that's just waiting for a semiconductor. And we apparently have two. Oh, but one is trapped in the arms unit, so there's one semiconductor to spare right now. And they're doing a great job loading this up. That's good. I see someone unhappy. How unhappy? It's that biologist. They're not dying. Emery K. Liu is not dying. And are they going to go get happy now? No, they're going to keep working, man. Whoa, hardcore. Going to get starch, yeah? And she's got the starch. Poor thing. Poor little worker lady. Let's watch her come through the canteen if we can get on the camera in time. Yeah, oh, we didn't get to really see her. Oh, we saw the back of her. I was actually wanting to look at the back of her to see her ponytail or whatever it is. But I don't think it's a ponytail. It's something else. I'm going to have to check that out later. I haven't really looked that closely at the character models. The engineers wear overalls. The medics wear kind of a shirt. It's kind of a nice shirt. And the biologists wear like green stuff that looks a bit elfy or something. And yeah, it was... what was that? It was a biologist. Okay, we're all done with that. I hope she goes to find some happiness now. That's Emery K. Liu again, right? And she's going to the tomato pad. Whoa, she's going to work herself to the bone. There's all these video screens in here, folks. It's all good. You can get more videoing. Okay, that was nice. Nicely traded. Let's check their overall condition. They stayed at excellent throughout a trade, and production's not completely in the toilet. They actually could, yeah, we got more money. Let's save with that extra money. That's nice. I like saving money. Ho, 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 ho. God, I'm such a humorist, eh? That's amazing. You know, that's been the case my whole life. If I make a joke, you can expect people to sort of groan and turn pale. They're really bad. They're so bad that they're not good bad. I just make bad jokes. I'm going to go up on the mountaintop and contemplate bad jokes here. This base isn't too bad. It's doing okay. It's kind of a distributed plan. I'm definitely wanting to rip out that damn power system in there, but maybe I can restrain myself to just ripping out the two turbines and leave the rest of it intact. No, because I've got to get to the... Oh, hey, I've got an idea. If I... hook the airlock to the pad? No, that's not going to work. That's not how it works. You can't do that. But if I did hook the pad to the airlock, would that make any difference in the demolition pattern here? No, I still have to rip everything out to reach the airlock. That would just save me ripping out the pad. That's all. It would save me ripping out the pad. So if we can do it, yeah, we can. So before we demolish, we'll throw that connection in and it'll save us. No, because we're taking out the airlock anyway. So I'm not the most logical person in the world. The dog just gave up on me and walked away. I'm really not the most logical person in the world. It looks like we're handling our work just fine. Meals are good. Everything's good. Check the grid. Water is what it is. We could even put in another water tower, honestly. That's kind of a thought. This could be water tower corner here. Of course, then if we get one connection hit, we lose all our water surplus capacity, right? Right. I see the point on that. So where else can we put a water tower? Let's get clever. Build exterior structure water tank instead of putting another extractor in. Actually, what does a water tank cost? It costs like 2. And plus the connection. And an extractor costs 2 plus the connection. It's extractor then. The tank will just stay there for decorative purposes. I can see why I never put many water tanks in. Okay, so all that can be pulled out and replaced with larger structures. And we could put like a power collector here and then bigger turbines all there. Or yeah, one giant solar panel and 2 giant turbines. That would be sweet. Kind of looking forward to that. That'll help us demolish out this by enhancing power. Okay, just check here. We're okay. What's the wind doing? It's really not doing anything, so... We're not gonna die. We do have to watch it, though, because we got many of the megawatt. Many of the megawatt being drained. Now, I am open to traders, right? We. The royal we? No. It's the we. It's anyone on the internet watching this. I hope you're feeling involved and enjoying. I'm a little slow. My episodes are a little too long, and I'm a little slow. I have really bad upload speed on my connection, like, just abysmal. And that is causing it to be hard to bring these episodes out in a timely fashion. I'm probably going to have to resort to doing shorter episodes. I do like to play for quite a while at a time, but I can always hit the stop button and then come right back. You know, there's nothing making me do that. Okay, I am just dithering and bithering. I've got to take a look at resources. The grid's fine. Resources are pretty fine. Meals are steady. Metal's slowly building up. Semiconductors are building up. Now that's nice. That's good news. Spares are on the cruise. Nice balanced production. We could almost bring one bioplastics processor back online, I think. Ore and steel are holding steady, so we're going to pull that one on. And just let that keep going, because we're getting a starch buildup. And bioplastics worth more to sell than starch. Oh, that took us down to one semiconductor. And it is not in that machine. Oh, it's in this machine. Right. Well, the semiconductor foundry is chugging along. It's at 3%. And it's not a very fast factory, the semiconductor foundry. So that's cool. We might bring in another pair of engineers here. I think so. After all, if they're not really needed, they can carry boxes. We're going to bring them in right now. I think we'll hold out on in terms of our base if we bring in a few more people. And I'm going to bring them in as engineers because they help with safety. And that's a trader. They help with safety, and they're going to build those bots with what puny amount of steel we're managing to. You know, we'll trade for steel if we have to. Oh, look, I said it and I got it, eh? Well, let's fill him up with trash. He's got the massive solar patent, and we could buy it. It's not the worst thing in the world to buy. Let's see what we can sell him in terms of our stuff here. We could sell him a few expensive things, I guess. Maybe like a couple of medical supplies. I don't think I'll sell a single spare. We could sell a couple of bioplastic. We're a bit ahead of the game on it. I guess we could sell one more medical supply. So that takes us up to 215 without spending any money. And so we could either buy steel, or we could spend some money and acquire the massive solar panel patent. Well, and he's got money as well. So let's take steel and money and talk patents later, because that's not the most valuable patent to us, although I will tell you, it's a desirable patent. It really is. Even on this planet that has less sunshine, I'm still wanting it, because it just means less structures, and there is a limit to the number of structures you can build, and I want a really decorative, pleasant base here. I want to make a nice-looking base that works well. So I want those patents. So I'm a little happier to take some steel and money for our goods here. It's not going to kill us. It's not going to kill us dealing with this trade. We're going to do it. Pardon me, that was gross. Nobody should ever sniffle on the internet. Like, seriously? Oh, foul thing to do. Better than blowing your nose. That's what I always say. Blowing your nose is, like, so disgusting. Matter of opinion, right? Yeah, we're open to engineers, and we're going to turn off traders after that guy, because he's probably going to interfere with production quite a lot. Oh, we got to watch for solar flares. I forgot. Okay, let's review the base quickly. Let's save game, review the base quickly. I've got this funny feeling about a solar flare. It's just like, is it coming? Is it coming? It's coming, isn't it? We can do like... Oh, we were going to build a water extractor. I totally forgot. Yeah, we were going to build another water extractor. I think that's a great plan. And power? We've got significant overgeneration during windy periods, which means definitely another collector. I've got a little thought of trying to build that junk in here. I'm going to see if it'll work. Because it's zero maintenance stuff. Oh god, those meteors. So I'm not actually going to X4 right now. I'm going to look into this building opportunity. So we build exterior structure, and we're going to start with a power collector. And I'll see. I might be able to put actual base out that direction. Oh, that would be so cool. I think I can. I mean, yeah, obviously I can. Let's just see what happens here. Pop it in, grab another one. We got to do this quick before they start doing any serious work on it. Yeah, I can put base out there. So that's not where I'm going to put the power and water structures. And I want base out this way, so this is kind of limited, and I'm probably going to want to demolish and replace these units. So power collector could go over here. Right here. Yeah, that's a nice spot for a power collector. Because that won't block me taking base out this way at all. And we're going to just lock that into the system there. Hi, Snoopy. Not right now, bud. In like an hour, pal. Yeah. In an hour, okay? Relax. We don't have visitor potential and we don't have an interstellar radio, so I don't need to amp up the infirmary because sometimes six people show up from outer space. People get sick in outer space. I don't need to deal with that right now. We got biology maintenance happening again here, but that's fine. Meals are steady. Ore is just about out. Steel is doing great. Bioplastics, fine. Medical supplies, gonna be fine. Spares, fine. Dying for that semiconductor. We're super gonna need a semiconductor foundry. Power and water. Look at them go on this power collector. Boy, they know what's good for them, don't they? So it's waiting for two, and it's got two coming, and I think there's an engineer carrying one of the... No, he's not. Yes, he is. So he might even build it for us. Let's just see. No, he's just gonna leave. It's okay then. Just leave then. Be fine. It doesn't matter if you just leave. It won't hurt us. So, yeah, we need another semiconductor machine. We're gonna bring in the more engineers first before we start more build out. We got to start on that, and we'll probably get, like, we'll get like a bot a week out of this if I keep arms switched off. If spares start to fall off or if steel runs out or something like that, I'm going to have to do some thinking. Oh, constructor bot took care of it, and the ship is done. Power collector built and connection probably built in a second, too. We're open to engineers. Keep an ear open for the ship. Now, let's just see. Look at that. It's not filling. It started filling and then it stopped. I guess we just dropped below production to fill it. Yeah, the wind's going down. Yeah, wind's going dead on us, so we won't fill that till the wind and sun are together. There you are. We won't fill that one till we've got wind and sun together. I guarantee you. And that's one reason we need the massive patents. We need to, without building too many more structures, we need to crank our power production up. We could use another laser, we could use another telescope, all that stuff. But, you know, the colonists didn't get a choice between building bots and building bars. And I think they'd like a bar, and I think a bar is fine for a spaceport as well. So we're going to put in a spaceport bar. We had this plan before. And, boy, we're hoping that power's going to come out okay here. Oh, yeah, that's filling now. So, great, we've just totally improved our power storage. And we were going to build a water device, too, right before we build a bar. Of course. And we've got the steel to build the water device. So steel production's holding. And, see, I'm going to take base out that way. I don't think I'd be able to blast out that hump and get it in there. That would be super slick. Wouldn't it? Oh, it really would be super slick. Let's just see what happens. Okay. Build interior structure, O2 generator. So if I took this, like, out here. No, it's just not happening, is it? What are you doing? Going to get ore? Well, aren't you taking the long way round? What airlock did you come out of? How's your oxygen level? What the hell? You felt like a walk, eh, Rosendo? I guess the other airlock might have been busy or something. Well, maybe we need another airlock soon. So if I'm taking base that way, I could throw an airlock out this way. Meh. Nothing needs maintenance over this direction exterior-wise. This all needs maintenance. This doesn't. That doesn't. So that airlock should suffice for maintenance purposes. You know, Rosendo went for a walk, but that's no reason to build an airlock. What we need is a water extractor, and we need somewhere reasonably scenic to park it. Maybe we can jam it off the side of this canteen. I think I tried that before, and I could only get the small one. Like, yeah, the small one goes, but then the large one won't. And to get it anywhere else, you're going to block expansion, I think. Well, let's pop it in and see if we can still expand. So pop that in and then grab an O2 generator and just see. No. So get that back out of there. Okay, that's no good. I guess it's going out here. I kind of thought, you know, I kind of liked the idea of a cabin out here. Okay, here's our engineers. We're going to count them. Because we're now hitting the basis. Personnel limits. We got three. Wow, we got three. Holy smokes. Well, they'll take on a few worker duties. Basically, for us. So, no biggie. Well, that's why we've got extra steel. We traded for it. I forgot. Okay, so our native production is still not necessarily ahead, but we are a trading base, and we can trade for steel. There's nothing to stop us. That's waiting on a semiconductor. There's now two semiconductors. Is something else using them? I don't think the meteor laser needs maintenance. If it does, I don't think it needs semiconductors for maintenance. Maybe it's just everyone's been too busy. Oh, look, there it is. So they'll start building bots now. That's great. I hope the frame rate and stuff isn't too choppy. I'm set way down to 42 frames a second because I was running it at 60 when I first tried the software and I was getting really awful jerky playback, but I'm not sure, that might have been other settings. There's a lot of different things I can change on the settings. So I'm going to leave it at 42 for now, but you know, I could try a higher setting on it. Let me know how bad it is. Let me know whether it's worth doing it. Okay, we're getting to the point where we can build this bar. Snoop, quit staring at me, dude. My dog is sitting beside me, staring at me without moving, with just this gentle look on his face. Because he thinks I'm taking him for a walk. Because I got up early today and I took him for an early walk. So he's had that certain number of hours where he thinks he's going for a walk. If he needs the bathroom, he can go in the backyard. There's no issue. He's just being snoopy. So I'm going to ignore him and continue struggling to place this freaking water collector. Maybe I can put it here. That looks like... I probably just tried this a second ago. This is like me. I just tried it a second ago, I'm sure. I'll throw it right in there. Bang it on. And can we still put other stuff on here? Yep. Okay. Well, we got the water generator figured anyway. That's skookum. So now that tower can stay for decorative, because I'm not so sure the 600 water in the tower would particularly help. 11 steel and going down. So we really are, steel problem. Ore is holding, going up even. Well, once we get some carrier bots going, we're going to have everyone a little less tired. and everyone just generally more happy. I'm going to put a push on the bot workshop. And I'm going to save with the push on. Snoopy, really? It's the neighbors. It's the neighbors. Those are kids. Go lie down or something. Seriously, buddy. No. That's enough. No. It's enough. Don't. Okay. Back to the show here. Glad we didn't get hit by a meteor while my dog was barking at me. It's a neighbor's kids playing in the yard. It's because they have that dog. Yeah, and you want to walk and everything. I know, Snoopy. Life's complex. Sit down and wait. Man, total distraction. Oh, well, we got the water extractor. Look at that. They built it while my dog was barking. They're fast workers. Will he do the connection? Will he do the connection? He did. They don't always. Sometimes they do. Sometimes they don't. Oh, no. I'm going to have to think airlock over this way. Because we're going to get a situation where, well, no, they'll still have access via this airlock, technically. No. Once I block that with more base, then that... Oh, the water extractor doesn't need maintenance. That's why I put it there. I make myself crazy, you know. But then I get over it super fast. We're open for traders. What's the grid doing? We've now got lots of water. We're drawing even more power, of course. I hadn't really bargained on that. But we are drawing more power. We've got 100,000 storage of power. And it's going 6, 5, 4, 4, 3. So, and how far through the night are we? Halfway through the night. I'm going to say that we've got the storage to handle this. And even to handle a bar. Snoop, pushing your nose under my arm isn't going to help either. He's just finally given up and gone away. He'll be perfectly fresh as a daisy and happy when I actually go to walk him, but I don't need someone staring at me while I try to figure out where to put this bar. Yeah, his life is important to me. I don't neglect him in order to play games or anything. He actually gets a really good ride around here. He has fun. Lots of fun. Speaking of which, we're having this bar right by the airlock. It'll be the airlock bar. This is the airlock bar. I'd like to call it the airlock bar and grill, but that's not happening. Because there's no food in it. We should put in a small canteen near the airlock too, but we're not really ready for visitors yet. So this bar will be for station staff, basically, and the bar will lead over to another security center and another airlock, so we can get another pad down here, and we'll get this stuff out. We'll get that stuff out. I want some patents first. Poor old carrier bot seems to be moving slowly. He's tired, eh? He's tired. Rosendo is always working. She just doesn't quit, although she's hardly ever at her station in the lab. Oh, someone is there working. And they're making the lovely medical supplies. Let's see how we're doing. We did sell some. We've gotten back up to 9. They don't recover quick. I better keep that in mind. I've got plenty of bioplastic right now, and all I've got to do with it is furnish a bar, so I'm going to just crank the infirmary up in case of, you know, like a lot of people getting hurt or something. Just whatever. I'm just going to have it ready. And there are only 2 medics, but at least we're trying. And yeah, I'm not getting the extra bed in. And there, in that one, I wasn't 100% careful in my placing. But even if you're 100% careful, you don't get that extra bed in unless, like, 1 in 10 times. And look, it totally looks like it would fit, too. Just, it really looks like it would fit, but it doesn't. I could pull those out and try again. But I don't think I've ever gotten more than 7 in a sick bay. I've done it in cabins. I've gotten 8 in cabins. I've never gotten more than 7 in a sick bay, so forget it. I'm not going to try. I don't think you're supposed to. It's some kind of, like, secret thing in the game. Okay, great. We got the push on the workshop. We've got semiconductors in the pipe. And arms are shut down. We're going to let bots catch right up. I know we've only got 1 bot production machine, but we're going to let bots catch right up and try to get so we have a few of them. So our stats here say we currently own two bots, a constructor and a carrier, and they're going to wear out soon enough. So hopefully we can just catch up and start building bots. Because look, there's that constructor bot doing his job, keeping engineering hands free to do things like man the telescope and protect the base. And now he's going to leave without building the other connection. That's funny. I'm going to need an O2 generator over here. Water situation. Excellent. What, have you lost your toy or something? What are you doing? Not you, viewers. Him. My ever-present loving companion. Yeah, bars can be crowded. So we'll put another O2 in. Heading out this way, I think. And probably double connected. In other words, we better let them build this connection first or they never will. If you isolate an area, they can't build it. And some areas, even though they don't seem isolated, they absolutely refuse to build. Okay, I'm going to save on this trader just because I'm in a saving frame of mind. And then I'm going to see what they've got for sale. They've got semiconductors and constructor bots. And an empty hold. We could sell a few expensive things. Let's dump a couple of those. Dump three of those. Dump two of those. We're going to do what we can here to get some stuff. Actually, I want that bioplastic. What am I doing? Oh, I've got 16. Well, I'll just give a couple bioplastic. I'm going to take a little risk there with that. And we're going to dump a bunch of junk into his hold here. I know, clicky clicky with the mouse. I don't know how to direct record the game. You're listening to my desktop speakers. And my... Oh, Snoopy, enough. Go lie down. Had it with that. Honestly, dogs. You gotta be a little firm with them. You know, if you shouted at your kid like that, they might wonder why you were mad at you. But the dog just takes it in stride. He doesn't care. I treat him well. So we're up to 410 in value here, and we haven't filled his hold. So this is pretty good. We're doing pretty good. We're going to really push here and try to get what we want. I don't think we dare sell more spares than that, even though we've got them coming. Or more medical supplies than that, even though we've got them coming. Okay, yeah, we dare. Dare to dare. That's 60 in the hold. Going to try to buy these semiconductors. And we're selling spares to buy semiconductors? I'm out of my mind. I'm just going to take this man's money. We're just going to take this man's money and then we're going to switch over what we're trading a little. I think we went a little crazy there. So that costs 227, so yeah. Mm-hmm. Exactly. That's a little more like it. That's a little more like it. Now he's got some room left in there, so let's dump in some more of this stuff that we're not totally looking to keep. Ah, overfilled his hold. Put back some vegetables because we're making a bar. We need veg. So we've gotten up to 300 with that. We can get a semiconductor. And really nothing else. So we're going to have to take some stuff off. Okay, well, what's most useful to us? Oh, not acceptable. Alright, fine. 295 to 293, that seems fair, that's reasonable. And we get money and a semiconductor. We don't get a bot, but, you know, with the semiconductor, we can build a bot. So we're going to do this trade. That's a lot of stuff to trade for money. We work hard as a vegetable trader, eh? We work hard as a vegetable trader. That, you know, something about the plurals in that statement don't work. A grammar technician would probably be horrified at what I just did. We're getting a bot already. Oh, that's great. And it's not a bot, so it'll start out at maximum health. Because it looks like bots start out worn, from what I checked there. Because we bought a brand new constructor bot, and I went and looked at it, and it was like half thrashed. And they're expensive, so totally not doing that. Yeah, another airlock out here. So we'll go O2 Gen Security Airlock. Yeah, that'll work. That'll probably look really nice too. How are we for products? Steel's dropping, so we're gonna let that continue before we ask for any more builds. We used up a bunch of steel building the bar, of course. So we're gonna hold off on steel use till we've caught up a little. And we will leave that bioplastic processor shut down. I might even shut down another one. I mean, no, because all this stuff consumes bioplastic. Like, spares consume bioplastic. Semiconductors consume bioplastic. Medical supplies consume bioplastic. We can't decrease bioplastic production from where it is. In fact, we might be smart to bring that back online. We'll just have to bring in a couple of workers. Good laser, nice laser. So we've got an extra bot now. Let's check the bot fleet. Yeah, 3 bots, 2 carry bots. Nice. And I'm sure the new one's just heading straight out to do its little duties. I bet that's it. I bet that's it. We're going to check its number. CR5, yeah, that's probably it. We can't catch a camera in anywhere here. We could have caught him in the canteen. He's pretty fast-moving little sucker, CR5 is. And yeah, he's brand new. Absolutely brand new. They wear quickly. You just have to keep building them. Well, with 2 mines, or at least making... Boy, steel's dropping. If steel keeps dropping, well, I'll just bring in workers. Oh, I didn't leave colonists open, did I? No, good. If steel keeps dropping, I'll bring in workers. Biology's holding the fort together. The last base, I kind of tried to focus on biology, actually. I ended up with lots of biology, but it wasn't that beneficial in the long run. I mean, we're a vegetable trader to start with here, but once we get further advanced in production, we can be trading bioplastic and even maybe something like guns. That would be cool. Arms trading base. Well, I like that idea. Arms trading base. That works well for me. Time check. Yeah, it's 3:30. I should probably think about getting a few things done. Yeah, here comes the person to remind me of that. Well, in a bit, Snoopy, in a bit. I'm gonna try to get this bar furnished out and get this trader unloaded before we go, Mr. Dog. We do need more guards. But I'm not convinced that our production and support network can hold many more personnel. And we might have to bring in more workers. So we're going to hold off on the more guards. There he is guarding an empty bar. That's perfect. That's a typical guard. Maybe we'll wait till we've finished doing this ship. Just save game here. Maybe we'll wait till we've finished doing this ship to furnish out the bar. Because, yeah. There aren't that many people here. Yeah, keep the push on with the bots, guys. That's awesome. Keep it going. If we can keep bot production ahead of bot wear out, then slowly we'll populate with bots, really slowly. We're totally going to have to build more engineering production in. Like, we're going to need another semiconductor foundry. We seem to be doing fine with 2 spares factories. That's holding us together. So, that's good. Okay, back down to X1 here. So that work is done. And we're gonna leave traders open. We're gonna leave traders open, is what we're gonna do. And keep on trading, because we need money. By the time the next ship lands, we'll have a bit more to sell here, so. And we've got production going. Now that everybody's done with that, let's check their general status. They are at good, so that was a tough strain for them. Plus, it's night, they're tired. Okay, there's what the populations are. Medics are a bit low. We seem to be doing okay on the medical supplies. And we don't seem to get too many injured people, so it's all good. I'm glad we have this massive power storage, because with this planet, you definitely see more off peak periods in your power system. Like, no joke about it. Snoopy, just wait. Man, the endless nose of inquiry. Let me furnish my bar, dog. Honestly. Seriously, man. Nobody manning the telescope despite massive engineering staff. That's a shame, but that's the way it is. So, drinks machine. We'll put them right at the door so they can be loaded and unloaded easily. Drinks machines at the doors. And each one of those only provides a certain number of drinks. I've found with bars, you kind of need to really pack in the drinks machines. That won't allow any tables. Damn it, you know. What, that doesn't allow a single table? Okay, pull that one. And put another one in right here. That's probably going to work a little better. Are we going to go with four of them? How many drinks does each one hold? Only three drinks to each machine. So we are going to go with four of them, I think. And we get some seating in. So there's a total of 12 drinks maximum prepared in the machines. And we've got six seats plus I think like two or three people can stand. So we've got like eight or nine seating. So we'll do one more table. Let's give the tables a view. You know, let's give the tables a view. That's really the way to go. Yeah, and then we'll put in some water fountains if we can squash them in. Yeah, nice. And so four drinks machines. We're just going to lay off that for now while we see to this trader. Poor dog's laid down on the floor and given up. I thought he'd given up earlier and then he came back. Persistent little bugger. Oh, they've got the massive storage patents. This time I think we're going to buy a patent. They don't have any bot patents or I'd have a terrible conflict in my mind. 660, it's going to cost us almost everything. So let's dump his hold full of what we can dump his hold full of. We can definitely take out a few spares. Take out a few of those. We're really going to just... Yeah. Exactly. We're going to totally lay down on that. Besides, we don't have much junk stuff to sell. Okay, that's his hold at 60, and that gives us 365 in value. I'm not willing to spend that kind of base money. So, we're really gonna blow some stuff here. I'm gonna take his hold up to 60 with the expensive stuff. We're not selling steel or semiconductors. We desperately need those. But we're selling spares, even though they take steel to make. And we're selling medical supplies, even though that could be total suicide, you know? His hold's full. We've got to 455. I'm pretty satisfied with that. So that leaves us with a little money in the base, like we need to build up money. In the previous base, I almost never had any money in the base. I just trade and trade and trade. But this one, obviously, I'm getting money built up for moments like this where there's a patent that I really desire. And that's a patent I really desire. In fact, I wish I could smash out that current storage and replace it now. That probably won't happen, but I'm happy to get this patent anyway. I don't see any point in spending any more. Really, I'm going to spend 15 spares. Like, that is madness. Just madness. For one patent. We're taking it. We're taking it, and we're saving game with it on. Yes, sir. Sorry about the extra work, guys. Sorry about the extra work. At least you got your bar sort of mostly finished. Yeah, oh yeah, they got on that. Well, we can add more drinks machines and more tables to that bar as we please. We have enough bioplastics to put in some video screens and junk for it. So, video screen. Bars? I don't think you can put potted plants in bars. I'm going to try to put these video screens where I'm not going to run into a problem with connections, you know? Oh, that'll go nicely way over there. Yeah, I'm just going to stick to two video screens for now. I should almost have another drinking fountain. Oh well, it's not finished. We can add more to it. There'll be some changes, I'm sure, in the bar. Wow, are we selling out our best things, eh? Dreadful. I better take the zoom off the bot workshop then. Although, look at him go making bots. Are we, like, picking up bots? Not really. But, that's great. I'll keep the push on the bot workshop. We didn't trade away steel, so we're not going to run out of steel because we're making bots. And spares, you know, coming along. Yeah, spares are coming along. Okay. It's all good. And we'll leave semiconductors going for now without... So we got the mega storage patent. Does that ever make me want to demolish all this stuff, dude? Oh my god. I think I'm going to. This is... Oh man, this is terrible. Am I really going to do this? Am I going to pull down the brand new bar that we just wasted all that time making and pull down my mega storage? Yeah, the little storage is almost empty, so we can pull it off. We're doing it. We're doing it. Oh man. Boom. Chaka. I'm so sorry, guys. Oh god. Okay, they're going to be busy little monkeys for a while. That was the dog, not me. And that actually means I should probably save game right here because that really smells foul. So I should probably save game right here. Oh, you know, do I want to save with a trader pending resources? I don't want some AI mess up out here. We're going to wait for the trader to go. And then I'll take Mr. Just Stank up the room so disgustingly. Oh my god, that was awful. The worst part is it smells like fresh chicken because I give him homemade food with fresh chicken in it. So that is the worst part. It's just awful and vile. We may have crippled the base with this trade. And we've given the colonists a crippling amount of work to deal with just to get massive storage. And they're not going to have anywhere to put all that trash. That's funny. So stuff's going to start building up in the hallways pretty quick. So that's great. So that's our first patent, eh? Ah, all that trading and we've got one patent. And we are going to put a massive storage in on this footprint here. I'm just hoping that Mr. Medium Storage isn't completely blasted by this. Okay, but we're going to save game and call the episode here. Hope you all have a good night, morning, whatever it is, wherever you are. And we'll see you next time.